Up, guys, welcome back for another reaction and react and relax TV. Okay, yes, so this one is best of Al Bundy, best of Bundy. How was your day? Best of Al Bundy. Okay, guys, yes, it's raining in the background, guys. If you hear the noise, it's raining. Okay, yes, I'm glad it's raining because it's very hot here in Jamaica. I'm here fanning like crazy, so I'm glad for the rain. Okay, yeah, so let's jump in at the video. All right, yeah,
can I get a woman?
Whoa,
a fat woman clip-clopped into the shoe store today.
Really?
And so I need something I'd be comfortable in. I said try Wyoming.
Hi.
Now, I don't know when they started letting women carry chainsaws. You know that new aerobics center up above me? The one with the sign, quarter ton discount? Well, today they played Van Halen's Jump. And damned if the whole herd didn't. It was awful, thing. The ceiling opened up, down they came. Blocking the I experienced cellulite winter.
Oh, no.
God, the humongity. A fat woman Godzilla's into the shoe store today. Asked for something she could wear to walk in the woods. Jokingly, I suggest she wear a sign that says, don't shoot from the front, I look human. Middle-aged woman comes into the shoe store. She's wearing a blossom hat. You know, the I'm just a cute young girl of 45 look. And she's looking for something cool to wear to a Crosby, Stills, and Nash reunion concert. So I suggest a nice recyclable paper bag to put over her face.
Jeez, no!
You know, so she can save the planet two ways.
Jeez.
So she maces me.
Yeah.
But as I lash out blindly, I think I clipped her a good one in the teeth. So from now on, it looks like she'll be gumming the words to teach your children.
No.
How was your day, Pumpkin? A customer comes in the store today. Tall, willowy brunette. Sits down, says she'd like to try on a pair of size 12 pumps. So I'm down there, you know, just doing my job. And notice she's wearing a garter belt like I like. And a nice pair of silk stockings. All the time she's smiling at me, all of a sudden, she uncrosses her legs like in Basic Instinct.
You saw it all?
It was fake, baby.
Yes.
You saw it all.
It was a guy!
Oh.
Oh, Peg, it was horrible. 16 straight hours of shoe-selling mayhem. Last thing I remember, I was down on one knee, waiting on an overflowing glacier of a woman. First thing they teach you when you're a rookie shoe salesman is when you get a fat one in the chair, never look up.
Why not?
I looked up, Peg. I saw underwear. It said Saturday.
So what?
Yeah.
It's Wednesday. Anyway, the next thing I knew, I was insane.
A customer comes into the diner, and he asks for the Norwegian salmon. Then he wants to know if it's fresh. I said, hey, Chucklehead, this is Chicago. This is not Norwegia, okay? Nothing is fresh. Well, I shouldn't say nothing.
I hate Christmas. The mall is full of nothing but women and children. All you hear is, I want this, get me this, I have to have this. And there's the children. And they're all by my store because they stuck the mall Santa right outside ringing his stupid bell. As if you need a bell to notice a 300-pound alcoholic in a red suit. Ho, 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 all day long. So nice as can be, I go outside, ask him to shut the hell up. He takes a swing at me. So I lay a hook into his fat belly and he goes down. Beard comes off, all the kids start crying, and I'm the bad guy.
This woman comes in, and she is so fat, she actually has three smaller women orbiting around her. So I'm trying to force a pair of size 13 shoes on her Jurassic feet? When she says to me that her husband just left her.
The plot thins.
So then the skinny woman with a hooked nose olive oils into the shoe store and says, I want something to make me look sexy. So I say, you'll have to wait a long time before someone that ugly comes in to stand next to you. Excuse me, boy. Now, I don't know when they started letting women carry nunchucks.
Jeez.
A fat woman hedgehogged her way into the shoe store today.
I'm telling you, Al Bundy was something else, where he could do his scenes, deliver those lines with a straight face. Like, imagine if you were a pig. Like, how many times would you bust out laughing when he started to talk? Like, would you be able to keep your line straight? Like, sit there with a straight face like she always does? Like, he's crazy funny.
I got to tell you about my day. I had to give a driving test to a woman who was so fat. He had to shoot a driver's license photo with a Hubble.
They have some problems with some people on this show.
Son, listen to me. I don't have time for one of your shaggy fat woman stories.
And you're the one always giving it to them.
Ask me how much I hate Halloween. More than that.
He doesn't care.
Now they make all us employees put on these costumes like some woman's going to say, gee, I wasn't gonna buy any shoes today. But since I see in a dinosaur costume, I will. And of course, the ride home from work wouldn't have been so bad if the kids had actually got gas instead of pinning the needle on the gauge full. But then again, I don't mind pushing the dogs through gang turf because I'm a mighty stegosaurus. By the way, did I mention how much I hate Halloween?
Go away.
Right?
Home sweet hell. So then, this woman comes in, who doesn't speak English.
She points at the shoes,
I point at the door. She points at the sky, and knees me in the nay-nays.
That woman comes to the gate. Her moo-moo covering what must have been 3 or 4 hymens.
Oh no.
Now she could exit through a little itsy bitsy turnstile or a huge gate. Guess which one she chooses. A line was forming. So I had to do something. So I got a tub of butter from the Delta Burke Let's Get Big exhibit. And oiled her up. Then I went over to Star Trek land, hotwired the Enterprise, and sent it up where no man has gone before. She goes flying like a vegetable out of dad's mouth.
She is.
Right into the Facts of Life fan club pavilion.
Real Al Dadah.
A woman comes in the shoe store today so huge she's protected by Greenpeace. And asks for a size 4 shoe. So, I ask her if she wants to eat them there or take them home.
Jeez.
She has the nerve to complain about my performance. A fat woman sloshed into the shoe store today. Said she was retaining water. I said not to worry about it. The dam of cellulite holding it back should keep us all high and dry for the next few years. Now, I don't know when they started letting women carry stun guns. Why am I early on what used to be my bowling night? Good question. Thank you for asking. Well, as I entered the bowling alley, ready for an exciting night of bonding, brewskis, and barfing, what did I see? Women bowling. Overhand. So naturally, I went up to one of these donut depositories and said in my nicest voice, "Bridget, out the door, Beefalo, it's my night to bowl." But instead of coming back at me verbally like I did to them, they took their doughy fist and they pounded on me until a mutual agreement was reached that I leave.
Yes.
Anyway, when I regained consciousness in a burning trash can, I realized, A, Thursday nights is now ladies' night, and B, you don't want to know how a bum puts out a trash can fire. A fat woman creatured her way into the shoe store today.
Oh,
guess what happened today at the shoe store?
Did a fat woman come in?
enormous.
Oh, Lord, that's crazy. All the fat woman jokes. Oh, Lord, I guess it's only fat woman go to his store. I guess to annoy the echo of him. Because he has a fat woman phobia, right? Guys, that was another Al Bundy reaction, comedy reaction, guys. I hope you all enjoy. And remember to live, love, and laugh. Okay, guys? Yes, sir. Bye.